The U.S. Marines campaign in SF2. Yes, last time, our last episode, we tried to defend against an armored mechanized assault, but it seems it took too many losses. There's a way to continue the campaign. There's an interesting campaign script, campaign progression I've explored in the end of the last episode, so you can take a look. But for me, I might replay the mission. Sure, it's now totally easy because we know what is happening. Normally you don't like this because it is not... If you replay a mission, it's... Because knowledge is very powerful, as already Sun Tzu mentioned it. If you know your enemy, you basically know you won half the battle. Yeah, in this case it's similar. Yeah, this time I definitely want to secure my... if you want to see the briefing or whatever, check the last episode. I definitely want to secure my trucks and my Abrams. I might put the Abrams, one Abrams here. This is a good position. Because back in the first try I had a problem, I had them situated here, but they were ingressing from all directions and rather become difficult, and then we were flank shot. We still need to watch out because I think could be that the AI plan is different, but also BMPs. In the worst case, this is not the super protected Abrams. In the worst case, an ATGM of a BMP can also penetrate. That's a lucky shot. Have something like this. Let's take a look. Yeah, that's okay. We might even use two. We want to secure the road and the trucks. Let's put the vehicles, even if they might not drive anymore. If you put a vehicle like this, it is stuck, but we know that the mission, I simply want to get over it. So okay, that's too narrow. We might still get engaged because they are higher than most buildings. So we get them from the roads. That was a problem, that they were standing on the road. Okay. Yeah, this is a bit cheap. Yeah, well, not from it's possible. But I think you can't drive anymore. Even if it looks valid. But I don't care. Yeah, this truck was pretty safe. This truck was not that safe. The left is in general not that secured. The trucks are too high. I mean, there's this covered, but exposed. But this time I will make sure I have... Yeah, damn it. I don't know what happened to the second Chevron guy. Can't remember that he got taken out. We had one Chevron left. So what happened to the guy on the left? And one javelin team I had in the back. Why is he missing his javelin? How did this happen? I don't know. Perhaps he missed it. There were two guys. Okay, whatever. You can immediately extract the javelins out of the trucks. As much as possible. Because they will become my main weapon against those tanks. Holy shit, how many? Six? Okay. Are you kidding me? Is this guy... Two guys can carry that many tubes? No, why not? Why not? He can't run anymore with this outfit, but I don't care. Yeah. Now we really have some chefs here. Let's see, there's a truck. So we got all. 1, 2, 3, 4. And this guy is carrying a spare one. How haben wir mal put in something like this? Something like this, you just... Yeah, again, we need to watch out for the flank. It's a bit tricky situation. Yeah, about the Javelin. I mean, last time it was situated somewhere here. I don't want to have it frontally on the buildings. Would be good, but on the left there, of course, there is no true roof. And also fire indoors, but it's rather on the other hand. Fire indoors. First, I guess there are people in come. Nine javelins. Three guys carrying 9 javelins. They can take out a enormous company. Other than that, spread between the buildings. I mean, we could also use this building. I'm not exactly sure. Javelins, you can fire them out of buildings, definitely. And I think they suppress. They might suppress you. There are some AT weapons you can fire, but they suppress you in order to simulate that firing from a building is rather stressful. It kicks up a lot of dust. And infantry is needed on the right because they will come over the ridge. On the left there is not a big threat. The left is more vehicle threat. So let's situate or orient towards the left. Get anybody indoor? No, no deployment needed. Sure, we could micromanage it even further and pick up all those. There are a lot of 83 millimeters for the smalls, but if he's sitting there, let's get a heat especially. Jesus, this guy is equipped like, yeah, look at this, 8 heat, 8 HE, 1 thermobaric. This guy's landed outside of the setup zone, I guess by accident. I want to get them immediately into this things here. Into the ditches. Javelins. We missed this. So if we hit more javelins. But yeah, if this team dies, they can't carry more, okay. So it isn't grayed out, interesting, it isn't shown. Yeah, then bring this guy here. Can he carry 2 more tubes? He can. Okay, now we are absolutely crazy. This is the javelin position here. If this gets taken out, good night. 11 javelins waiting here. Yeah, this guy stitches. Ditch, ditch. And yeah, bring me all those smalls. Let's get at least the smalls absolutely armored up with heat and HP rounds in order to combat them plenty of stuff. But could be that the plan is completely different and this time they will come from here. It would be of course funny because I'm now situating towards this. Except this won't be the case. Yeah, you guys also get out of this zone there. I do not want anybody in the open. Inside. Undeploy. Protect the Abrams. Is there any truck that has spare? Yes. I'm not sure if this is a good idea, but they get resupplied 50%, so it's fine. It's not complete that the ammo is lost, because I'm sometimes not sure how ammo is handled. But I think the teams keep the ammo and the vehicles are dry then. The ammo is not returned to the vehicle after the mission. This can sometimes lead to problems. I'm not sure if this was a good idea, but now we will stick to it. It can happen that next round they will keep this, the next mission they will carry over this absurd amount of ammunition. I mean, it's fine, but they can't run anymore because they're carrying tubes all over the place. And yeah, this can be problematic. Do we want that to be? Squad, stick to them. We change the building. Okay. Still some guys on the road. They could stick there, but let's bring them somewhere else. Yeah, you belong to them. Let's stick to them. Inside the vehicles. I mean, they can man the 50 cars. It's also rather exposed. Yeah. I mean, you can't hide completely from them. Towards here. Okay, something comes. Blasted. Humvees look good. Trucks look also from this truck. Like put it to this here. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, the observation armor at night, you observe from whatever, but not from the road. It's not armed, so we can do a target check. Okay, small. Still one small left. I mean, just keep something on the left just in case they, I don't know, drive up, but this time I think it should be straightforward. It should be straightforward this time. But do not engage infantry targets. I mean, 500 meters or 600 meters is rather a joke. But Elite, do not underestimate Elite, they might... Yeah, but for the time being, do something, I don't know, I think effective range is 200, 300, perhaps. 600. Rather hard to hit. Okay, now the tow Humvee. The best strength of the tow Humvee, not sure. Can you put it between buildings? I don't think so, it's not high enough. But I think this is a good position. Let's see. Yeah. Something comes in the flank, will be roasted. Yeah, beautiful. Abrams, two Abrams. One Abrams is here. I think one is not enough. Either I create a strong point with two Abrams covering somewhat each other, because they might get otherwise overwhelmed. And one Abrams I put either here, it is very offensive. Yeah, but it can function. I mean, it stands there, and if a T-90 drives up, bam. Let's check the LOS here, but yeah, let's bring me the... No, not the, the all HQs, okay. Somebody cut the grass here. What is it marsh? Let's see. This is this spotter is hold down, not bad. Partially hold down. The problem is, when they spawn... Let's see, read that. Yeah, but I like it. But it could be the pro. Let's say the T90 spawned somewhere. I think they spawned somewhere here. Yeah, this, the problem is you never want an enemy to spawn right into. Yeah, this is not going to happen. Yeah, but I want to take out the T90s indirect. Sometimes if they spawn right in your face, they will see you before you see them. And what you want is that the enemy drives into your LOS always. This of course doesn't happen if they magically spawn. So I might also put them in an indirect fashion here. Or do I want to keep him on the road? Like this. But this is what we are supposed to. Yeah, exactly. Let's see if we can. I mean, on the right he's hidden. This looks not bad. Yes. At least to some extent the rear area is hidden, but if they drive up here, bam. Yeah, this is good. Should I want to position a bit to the left? Left is better protected, but little less. And we will definitely also have T-90s here. They could fire from the hill into our vehicles. And we have only one javelin, and this javelin might be suppressed in the beginning. Yeah, come on, Abrams, lead away. And this is not a true attempt. I mean, I will try to cheese my way through, because I already had already a try on this mission. But yeah, defense missions are rather fun. It's a bit better, but it's okay. And last Abrams. Can I hit these positions here without being exposed to other positions? Too narrow. Yeah, we go for the strong point solution. I mean, by this I mean. One Abrams here, one Abrams forward, or like this. It's what vehicles do when they are in the open. might even work with target dogs in order to prevent them from turning, because turning can screw you up. On the other hand, if this gets overwhelmed, this tank is absolutely exposed. What you can do sometimes is like this. This is good. Then the flank of a vehicle is, but this is exposed. You need minimum three vehicles. There are some setups like, you know, protect the flanks. But I think this is a way more dangerous position than this here for flank shots, but you never know. Try this out. Yeah, no, give me a moment. Arti. Cover something in on those obvious positions.
We need some indirect!
Roger. Request fire mission. Out.
We need some indirect!
Request fire mission out.
Damn it. I need to finish my coffee.
Requesting fire mission, over.
Damn it. Yeah, the rest of you will keep. Yeah, make sure that you don't die.
Out.
Man, oh no, not. Jesus. Nah, do I want to. Yeah, I have trust in you. This vehicle, I wanted to use somebody that is dismounted. Because if this vehicle explodes, we still can dismount it. I don't see that much use in that vehicle. Yeah, that's better. But stay away from it in case it explodes. That's it. Yeah, the intermission, and we also need to pressure that hard. If we destroy the dangerous vehicles, we can. The cost is even air force scheduled and whatever. But in most cases, I guess the enemy will simply retreat or surrender before this becomes. What is this? Go. Hit that building, go. Are you kidding me? Random hit in the vehicle. Yeah. I mean, not random, it's really big. But it looks like they didn't aim for this. This was a stray round from this mission hitting the truck. ADGM spotted. Who is that? This is not air blocking smoke, right? You should identify him if he comes over the ridge. Simply hit the building and stay there. Ah, so fucking good. Fucking good. So we will run all over the place. Yeah, yeah, the arty is also rather random in this mission. This time it got a bit harder. It is sometimes, I think, some scenario designers. I mean, if you go for a casualty threshold, then you into a absolute. The Marines never would deploy like this. And hit Arty into it is random. If you could even suffer, I don't know, Abrams speed pace. Then you put out the people out of the mission. BMPs. Identifying. I really hope our javelin stays safe. Is it alive? Because otherwise we can restart immediately. Okay, BMP's advancing. Yeah. And I'm here. Again, let's expand the target arc a few. You have LOS here, you know? So wouldn't be just your optics? No. Looks like this guy needs to take the job for now. Could be that is this air blocking smoke? Yeah. So come on, open your eyes. Are we ready to... Not yet, I don't want to bring up yet. If they deploy the tanks, on the other hand, I want to start attacking from the distance. But I don't want to target this this APC stuff. Is the RT's over? Still calling me as heavy. They are still calling me. They can't bring the Jeff up. Hey Crystal, dude, you are a machine. I start watching you at 10 a.m. my time and now it's 3 a.m. the next day. I will hang around but I have work in the morning. See you maybe. Yeah, have a nice day. I also have some stuff to attend, but I need in gaming. I can't play this. What do you call it? Pieces of it. I need to get a complete cake eaten so I can concentrate on my real life. Yeah, I mean, that's fucking random artillery. And then you boot it out of the mission. And I think the Abrams are really expensive. But sometimes, sorry, if you call in so heavy hitters and then, yeah, please don't be pressure this low. I think it's good. Yeah. I think the same. I simply hate RT. Especially because in some missions RT is so random. I don't know what they do. Sometimes this RT hits here, sometimes it hits here. And in a playthrough, You get not hit, in other playthrough you get absolutely wasted. I'm sure that's warfare. I don't like them. I think it's strange to combine it on the side. Combine it with some. Yeah, keep your pressure this low. Okay. Can't engage this guy? Yeah, hold down as he turning. Wow, man, I see nothing, but if you see, I'm fine. DMP, watch out. turn your target arc and focus on this area. Other focus here. Ah, T9 is spotted. This is finally over. This shitty heavy artillery. The complete Marines division deployed into this. Nobody was thinking, Captain, Colonel. Yes, I don't know. Do we really? Yeah, I think it's fine. Yeah, they have good coffee. Okay, yeah, let's go, 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 go. Bring the Jeff up, and then it gets hit immediately by RT. This also seems to be more arty than last time. It's really annoying the heck out of me. I can't remember seeing that this bit stuff here. Yes, thanks spotted. Let's give him some. This is fucking hard. Bit reactive armor. Who is firing on him? What's it up? Who hit him? Hit reactive armor. Hit by what? What was this vehicle that fired on it? Ah, it was one of the Abrams. Yeah, interesting. You don't see that often. Abrams deflected flank shot by reactive armor. One, this is not bad. And now he kills the Abrams. Good shot. Three eliminated. Three, I report, enemy three in our AO is eliminated. Don't get it. Javelin firing. I hope the Javelin is aiming for the other vehicle. Except for this. Okay, but we got this. Okay. Protect please your vehicles. What the heck, I'm... Most trucks are destroyed by random artillery. Good job. People, I think the T9 is eliminated. Feel free to engage what you want. But this is so random, and this arty, when we played first time, it wasn't the case. I mean, what the heck? Let's do a plan without. Let's do a plan where you hit, I don't know, by 400 shields or 400 shells of 120s. That will take out all the vehicles. No matter what you do. Then let's boot them out of the campaign. Because too much casualties. Look at the shells. They're sitting in buildings and ditches. Call in our RT, one of the Abrams, you have thermals, call in on this stuff here. Harass? No, why not?
We need some indirect!
Give me a fucking way this is up. all trucks destroyed. Really, if the campaign boots me up, if we are booted out again, it's just nice that we don't play. Pocket under bad design. Box all your units into a position. No commander ever would select them and hit this ship this one thing you have. It wasn't the case in the first place, but it's shit, I think we hit it. Next time call in, I don't know, 10 rocket strikes. Even more fun. Man, Abraham, stop! Always with me. Reluctant to protect our vehicle. Is it no? Yeah. Ah, it's a tow. This is he's sensing something. He's aiming. Come on. I see still reloading. You are about to get to die. Quickly bring up that. I don't care for this shit artillery. You simply bring that thing up. Aiming. It's a slow reload. He's not seeing the. What the heck are you not seeing that? My guys will not see you. Penetration, let me guess. Something hit it from the top. Fire? Or can you call off this fuck shit and deliver mission? Do I need to listen to it? For me to play for it. I don't know, race all buildings in one. Problem is not that we're getting shelled, it's completely fine, but getting shelled like this and then putting requirements like, yeah, keep casualties low, I mean, it doesn't make sense, it's not fault-free. And then random artillery. Last mission is still not. This is for AI, but by randomly running to our ship plan, it sure can happen, but okay to fire into your setup zone like this, especially if you can't do anything. But then at least.
Record his target, change the position, target suppressed up. And a miss. Record his target, change the position, target suppressed up.
Absolutely obvious. Just annoying. I guess people would reload. Ah, oh, shit, I got the RT, let's reload. Well, they now fire 1 hour, but Mamma mia. Can I cease fire, or do I need to wait for every straggler? Are you sure? We could also move out. for you. Drive tanks, handle it. Simply blast them into pieces. I don't care. Find them, kill them. Get this mission over. Give me the NCV. Battle NCV. It's this I think is absolutely driving nuts. First playthrough, fun. Put it out. Second playthrough, you now know what you do, but yeah, let's. Let's fire into the setup zone and 500 shells. Who is responsible for the RT? Tell it me. Yeah, take the higher ground. I don't kind of mind RPGs. Let's do a thunder run like back then in Baghdad. Simply drive up the vehicles, have fun. Yeah, but this I don't think a good idea here in reverse. Come to the highway. Let's do a Baghdad thunder run. Because I can't stand this shit artillery wheels. Yeah. Next time expand here. Raise all buildings please, because this really feels like some people say in multiplayer there are some guys that try to hit the setup zone with the RT. I mean in a defense mission it's completely fine to do this, but it's a combination of simply utter annoyance, I think. You're shoehorned into our position. Nobody ever would take a position like this. Absolutely. Not even a civilian would choose a position like this. Not even a guy without absolutely zero knowledge about anything would choose a position like this. And then send in 1,000 shells out. What the heck are you doing? Abrams, you are not transported. You don't need to go into the... I know he sees infantry there, but please. It looks like this the transport configuration of tanks. Shot for RPGs here on this one point. Let me get over this mission. Yeah. I can see it, we'll get booted out. Yeah, you should have watched better for your vehicles. Casualties not managed. You should better watch to avoid this RT shells. Fuck hell. It's absolutely annoying. Get over it. That was the last mission. Why nobody told me, and I wouldn't have to suffer through this. I was thinking there will come another mission. Damn it. Oh, man. I mean, I can't even delete it. On the other hand, I leave it. Yeah, we got, I guess, the most shit plan. Missions come with different plans. Can everything happen? In one version you might get hit by RT, in another version you might get hit by, I don't know. It's even possible, I think, completely to make mission experience different. I think this was a really absolute annoying. Okay, I will shift now to Normandy. Let's see. And we'll return 5 to 10 minutes and then we'll play the Bloody Ride campaign. It's one of the last campaigns on my list. Finally, too. And then my list is almost finished and I can retire peacefully. Okay, see.